All right, in the last video, we covered partitioning under the command line for Linux. And now we're going to use the graphical user interface, or rather, a graphical user interface. That's the thing about Linux, is it's a very diverse ecosystem. You can really make it however you want it to be, so there's many ways to do the same things. Unlike with Windows and Mac, where there's really just one way of doing a certain thing. So for this, I'm using Ubuntu Mate, but underneath all of this, it's still the Linux command line. So if I do lsblk in the command window here, you can see that I have the same, about the same results as I did in the previous video. So I'm going to be using a utility called gparted, and this may or may not be installed by the version of the operating system that you're using. If you need to install it, you can open up the command prompt, and if you're on a Debian-based system, you would do sudo apt install gparted, which tells the computer to install the program gparted. I've already done that for this machine, so I can skip ahead, and down here in Applications, go to System Tools, and then gparted. The way you get to it in your particular version may differ. Again, that's just how it works with Linux. I want to authenticate as the root user, or the super user. And I'll come up with this window here. So this window shows you the one drive at a time. And you can see here that there's three different partitions shown for drive SDA, which matches what we saw in the terminal here. You can see here that there are also three partitions, SDA 1, 2, and 5. This has 1, 2, and 5. Not including this unallocated part, we can ignore that. But to get to the other drive, SDB, we want to go up to the top here and go to this drop-down menu. Click on that, go to SDB. You can see that the entire thing is unallocated. So what we want to do is go up to Device, Create Partition Table, and then we have the option to choose between several different types of partition tables. Let's just stick with MS-DOS. It's pretty much the standard. The other alternative for would be GPT, which is a more common Linux file system or partition table, but let's just stick with MS-DOS for right now. Click Apply. And now we can create our partition. So I'm going to go up to Partition here at the top, New Partition. And this is really just like a front end for FDisk in a way. It gives you the same options, the same kind of interface, but it's a little bit more easier to use because you can see you have the graphical components. Like I can take this slider, for example, and move it around, and it's going to automatically adjust the size of the partition and all that. I can also move the physical partition around on the drive, so I could place it in any arbitrary location that I want. So it's easier to do it this way than, you know, using a pencil and paper and trying to calculate the partition sizes and the locations of them. So I'm just going to go ahead and use the entire drive like before. And it defaults to ext4 for the file system. This is the second part of the operation that we did in the last video. This program does both the partitioning and the file system at the same time. So we don't have that extra step. I'll just leave it as ext4. It already has primary partition as by default. I'll give it the label drive B and press add. So it hasn't done anything yet. What it's done is it's keeping all these changes in memory. So the actual drive itself has not been touched yet. But when we go to click the check mark up here, it's going to write all these changes to the drive, and any stuff that was on there before is going to be erased. So we want to make sure that we've got these right, and then click Apply. And that'll take a second. So now you can see here I have the SDB1 partition. I'm not going to actually close out of gparted now. And back at my terminal window here, I'll do the lsblk command again. And you can see I have SDB, which now has SDB1 as our partition. And in Linux, most types of Linux, or most distributions for Linux, if you go to the file browser, you can see here, there's drive B. And if I click on it, it will automatically open it up and it's ready to go.